Hello friends, welcome to my channel. This is another tutorial on PHP and MySQL. On this tutorial, I'll show how you can create shopping carts using jQuery, Ajax and Bootstrap for the design. And I've already started my server, and I'm going to use just 4 images for this, right? So let's go on and create folder in our server. Right, see www and then create new folder, and then name it cart, and then open it, and then create new folder, name it img, right? Img. And then you can add as much as image you want inside, right? But I'm going to use only 4. Just 4 images. Okay. But I just changed the names of the images to numbers. So cut, just drag it to your editor. I'm using Sublime Text. So create new file, name it index.php. okay, and then the folder, create another folder, name it include, and then create new file inside the include folder, and then name it connection, right? connection.php. okay, so let's create our database, then we connect it, right? I've already started my servers. So localhost, I'm doing this for those who are beginners and new to shopping cart tutorial, so that you don't get any error and you understand everything. That's why I'm taking you through all this, right? And also, if you have problem, let me know in the comment section so that I'll come and then I'll help you, right? Okay, so let's log in and then create our database. Okay, so click on database and then create new. I'm going to name my cart, right? So come and then creation, create. Okay, and then the table will be items. I'm going to need about let me choose 5. I'm coming. Okay, so the ID, and then name, price, and then image. Okay, so let's remove that rule left, so just -1 and then click on go. Okay, set to variable character worker. Oh, choose the length. Okay, and then set the primary key. Save the table and okay. So let's insert data into our database manually, right? So let's click on insert. So the ID is auto increment, so the name be this, the images. So let me check the names, right? Watch. Okay, so the name will be watch1. Then the price will could be let me set 200, and then 1.jpg. Let me check this the file extension. Okay, JPG. Okay, and this one too. GF5. This be JPEG, and then Y2. Price will be 120, and then image will be 2.JPG. So click on go, and then here I want to edit this one, so set this to 150, and then the image that you want to use, you check the file extension and then you add it. So I'm on the third image and it's JPEG. Okay, it's JPEG rather. And then JF5, and then the name will be phone instead, it's not a watch. This will be watch 3, and also let me change the price to 190. His phones are $200, so let me insert this one too. Okay, so this is the table we are going to use for our shopping carts, and then so let's connect the database and then continue from the right. So we store connect because my SQLi can connect. Localhost username equals root, and then empty password, and then database equals cat. Okay. And here, if we have to add the HTML structure, title equals shopping cart. And then cart. And I'm going to use a Bootstrap, so let me add the CD. Okay, so Bootstrap CDN. Started. Star sheet. Let me copy all. And then I'm going to use some Ajax, so I have to add the query CDN too, right? So the query CDN, compress, then click on copy. Okay, so let's add our structure here. So div class container, div class call md12, Dev class rule. Okay. So inside this dev where we will print our shopping cart data inside. So have to ask a class here for our Ajax course, right? So show cart. Okay. So what we need to do now is to come down here and then create new script tag and then add the jQuery format document dot ready function, right? Let's check if our link is working. So let's print, let's select high and see. Sometimes it can fail you, right? So let's run it on localhost. Cut. Okay, everything is set, right? So let's print our shopping cart data. So let me store it in a function. So function show cart. Okay, so we have some Ajax. Method set to post and then URL show cart dot php. Then the success function. Okay. So let's create new file, copy, and then paste it. Okay. So include the connection and it's right in include folder slash the connection dot php, right? So let's get the data from the database. So our query will be select asterisk, select all from the items. Okay, no order. So my SQL query. And then the query, right? So we use the while loop here. Role equals MySQLi fetch array. Okay. So let's do this here. Our output for empty string and then if MySQL li num rows this race is less than one, Then we want our output equals no data, right? Or no item. So now we will store output here. So div okay. So let's add some classes here. Class equals column D6 4 instead, right? No, 4, and then I'm add shadow small, and then MX 1. Okay. So let's add the image. So SRC. Image. So let's close this and set we should specify the height, and then so that it won't give us height equals 150 pixels. Then we add the name in H5 row name, then you can copy this. Then price, and then add dollar sign here. Okay, or can do this. Okay, let me leave it like that. Input. Set the type equals hidden, and then name equals price, and then ID equals price. Copy this one too, and then the name, and then here to the name okay, and then input type equals number, and I set the name to quantity. Then the ID also quantity, right? And then add some class form control. Okay, so close it, and then let's add our submit button. Input type equals submit. And then name equals add to cart, then class BTN, BTN, one, okay, and then value set to add to cart, and then add ID, and the ID will be this current ID, right? So she store the ID inside here. ID. Okay, so let's send this, and then echo output. So let's run this and see if we get some error. Come back and fix. Oh, I haven't called the function. Still, oh, sorry. Class show card dot html, then passing the data. Okay, get some error. Client 33. Okay. Have to close this. Line 13. Okay. Oh. And then make two. We did some mistake here, so we have to add a folder where the image is, right? So refresh it. Okay, so you can see it's done, and then let's add this here. Let's add some value here, equals 1, and then let's create some simple header on top of our shopping cart, right? So they include folder, create new file, name it header.php. Here html, nav class navbar expand lg, and then navbar duck vg duck. Okay, later shopping cart, and then div mro2, you will nav, and then add this here, li, add the class nav item, and then add link, Google.php and then cat, and then let's add some class here. Nav link. Okay, so copy this and then paste it again. Okay, let's change these two items. We create this file later, car.php, and then now okay. So let's link this here. Include. Slash the header. Okay, so let's try this. Rename. Try it again. Let me change the CDN. So let's pin your one. Bootstrap CDN 4. So copy. And then ignore this ones, and then save. Okay, let's leave with some style here. So class, set the text with white, and then vibrant and set the text with white as well. Okay, and shortcut, change the colon to 3. Let's enter this. So add class equals text center, and then let's add the value of the hidden name. So the row, and then the name, right? Okay, so you can copy this. Then paste it at the price, and then change the name to price. Okay. percent. Let's add some of the white, make it 250. And let's see. Okay, this is okay. And then style, margin left. Pixels, okay. So let's come here and then let's cut this and then let's add the jQuery command dot ready. Okay, so paste it again and then okay, we need to get the add to guard button, so let's do this. Document dot on click, then the function. Okay, add to cards and then add this class, add so dot add, and then we get the ID of this button, so let's store it in a variable and then use the this keyword dot attribute of ID. So let's check if it's working. Okay, one, then the phone was 4, right? So it's 4. So let's write our Ajax codes. Oof. Set the method to post. To cut dot php and data success function pass the data parameter and then when it says we should alert some message to the user, you have added new product or new item. So let's do this here. Let's store the var name. ID, it's not a class, so dot value and then price. Dot value and then and the quantity. Okay, so should work on the data ID equals this to ID, and then name is to name, comma price is to price, then quantity is to quantity. Okay, so let's create this file. You can copy. New file. So let's start session. Session start. And then if they set our session name will be cat. So if you set cat, else we store the items in array. So equals the array function. So the ID is to the value post ID, comma, and then name to the post name. Price then the quantity is to the value quantity. We store this inside our session. Cut item, sorry. Okay, so if we've already added new we've already added items and want to add new one, so cart ID equals array column, so we check, we first get the cart ID. If not in array, post ID, session card. Okay, just copy this and paste. Okay, and then click header. Then copy the name and create file, new file, name it like that. paste HTML, cut. So here we just need to include should start the session first. Session starts, and include folder slash header dot php. Let me check if our shopping cart is working. If it's set, session card. Bar dump, session card. Okay. So let's try this and see. Getting the message. Dot file. Let me check here. Arrow 0. You have the name, watch 1, and price, and then the quantity equals 1. Then we need to add index. Just copy this link and then I'll paste it here. Container. Class call MD12, then div class let me print the table here, add the class table. Dead. And then let's start the header. TH item ID. Item name. TH. Item price, TH item quantity, connection. Okay. Then let's add our PHP tags here. If not empty, our session card. Else, let me close that PHP was here, and then TR TD class. Text center, and then add call span to 5, and then no item selected. Okay, and MY5. So let's try this. Of 48 space between okay. Let's do the same here. PHP. Oh. For each session card. PHP, and table row, and the table data. Value ID. So name, and then value price, and then quantity. Let me see. Modify. Oh. Okay, let's add a button. CD class BTN. Send in the remove ID value ID. Okay. BTNO ninja. Total price equals 0. TR table data total price TD So probably total price equals total price plus the value quantity times the value price. So let's circle our total price here. Okay. See the other call span of 2, and then cut number format. Let's try to add new item and see. Okay. So you can see heading. Oh, there's some mistake inside and I hope you have realizing that the names are the same and then the price, right? So I need to check that. So I'm copy this, cut it instead. Cut and then go and paste it here. Okay, and then one thing left. Shortcut. Let's add the ID. Okay, so you can copy. Paste it here too. And then come here and then that's the ID. ID and then ID okay, it's left with one. Okay. Now our total price is being printed and so watch one it was a mistake, so and we fix it. That's why here we get the work three and then the price, the quantity. So let's work on remove and then remove all. So let's add or you can copy this. Then change the BTN to danger warning instead. And then set this to clear. Clear all. Let's see. Okay. Then come here and then copy. Then paste it here and then let's add the script tag. Command dot ready. Dot dot clear all. Oh yeah, it was clear all. Dot click function. ID equals this doesn't need the ID. So Ajax. C'est des méthodes de poste. The URL to action dot php. Then the success function. Let's get this file action.php new file and save then start your session. Session start. Action. Clear. Should add the data. You have cleared all items and terminate it. So if we set post action. If post action equals clear. Okay, so if equals clear of if action equals clear, then you want set. Session card. Okay. So remove or clear. Okay, no data. Then price equals 0. Right, so let's try to add new items. And then the phone start 100. Okay, so cut. So we have this cut. So let's work on the remove button. I'm going to remove. Click. Need to get the ID first. Dot attribute ID. Can copy this because we are going to work on inside the same file, and then change action course remove. Have remove. Item with ID. Okay, so let's work on these two, and if post action equals remove, then for each session cut, and then if value ID equals the post ID. I think I didn't include that here. ID is to ID, right? So let's come back on the file and then set cut let's save and go and try. So click on remove and it's gone. Remove. The reason why it's I didn't use Ajax to print and we found the tutorial, and also thank you for watching. Don't forget to click on the subscribe button so that YouTube notify whenever I drop new tutorial, and you can visit my channel, and there's a whole lot of tutorial here. You can watch any of them, right? So thank you once again. See you in my next tutorial. Bye.